You know, one of the things that I used to practice a lot too was the legato type playing. Mm-hmm. You know, I did all the picking stuff, and you can do that. When I was much younger, I was much more fascinated with picking. Right. I don't really, now I like phrasing and I like legato. So I used to do things, and this is a great exercise where you just, it's a flutter. And you do that until you're blue in the face, basically, where you can't do it anymore. And you'd be surprised how hard it is after a minute and a half to, and listening and making sure it still sounds good, and doing it all over the neck, and then using these two fingers at different speeds, making it sound good. And the only way you're going to do that is by listening really carefully and then molding what you're doing based on what you're hearing. So, I mean, does it sound like this? Or is it? And then, so if you can just, for like, until your fingers can't stand it anymore, you'd be surprised how it's going to change so many things. And of course, again, all over the neck, you got to do it. And then I would do that till all those kinds of things. And that's just two fingers. Yeah. And then you go to these two fingers. And does that sound as good as? Now, there's a cool riff in there. I don't know what it is yet, but it looked cool at least. And these two fingers, you know, and these two. So every combination of two fingers, and then every combination of three. And it may start off, you know, a little. Take a breath. If you stop and take a breath and relax, the shit just starts coming together. And then just do every combination. You know, any distance, you know, any kind of stretch. The only thing is it's got to sound good. And if it doesn't, find the patience to go back and here's how you find the patience. You know that if you do that, then you're going to eventually be able to play it, and it's going to come out amazing, and it's going to sound great. So that's the incentive. I would first recommend being methodical and going through each of the combinations of trills and distances and places that you can think of. Starts to hurt after a while. And then. It's a little difficult. And then all of these different things. And then with the. And then. But even if you just. Go on as long as you can. And the trick is, if you want to go longer, you relax. It seems like you got to, oh! No, it's about relaxing. And then it flows. It really starts to flow. So then, you know, there's the, just the playing and making it sound musical. That's just, I'm actually just thinking about trilling and stuff, you know. another cool thing to do is just one string, you know? That's a good exercise. You just play scales with just one hand. I'm kind of focusing on the legato trill thing. I mean, I might not normally play like that,
right.
But I'm demonstrating how you focus on a technique, and it gets easier. But if you go, if the notes aren't coming out, just break it down, relax, and break it down to two notes. Does that sound good? Does it sound right? So you go slower. Can you hear every note, or does it wrong? Wrong. You know what I mean? You want. If I was, okay, I'm getting carried away again, so. The thing is it's legato, meaning it's flowing, it's connected, the notes are long and they're. Going across strings without picking, it's. You know, that's a practice. You break it down. Does it sound right? No. I'm trying to screw it up, but you know. Hear every note when I go to it. So that's legato, and a great way to practice that is those flutter exercises.